Virtual Homeopathy presents homeopathic notes in video format. Consider subscribing. Today's video is about suppuration in silicea. The two characteristics of action of silicea is that it is slow and deep. Action is slow, complaints develop slowly, acts on sluggish constitutions. It is capable of rooting out hereditary complaints. Silicea produces inflammation about any fibrous nidus and suppurates it out. In a silicea individual, an injury usually suppurates and forms a scar that is hard and nodular. Silicea acts on the indurated scar, forms abscess and opens them out. In silicea, if a splinter lodges, a deposit takes place around it and the splinter remains. When silicea is given, it inflames the fibrous deposit and pushes it out. In a silicea constitution, an old ulcer heals with induration. Silicea opens up old ulcers and heals them with normal scar tissue. A caution in prescribing silicea is in tuberculosis of the lung. If there is tuberculosis, silicea establishes an inflammation and throws it out. Hence, it should not be given in advanced stage of tuberculosis. However, it is indicated in small lung abscesses with no tendency to heal. Silicea is also suited in later stages of pneumonia and chronic bronchitis. After violent exertion and overheating, gets in a draft or takes cold from a bath, cough and wheezing develops. There is a dry teasing cough with hoarseness which is aggravated by cold and ameliorated by warm drinks. There is flushes in the face during the day. Silicea is indicated in a variety of eye complaints like boils around the eyes and lids, pustules on lids, abscesses, tumors of lids, styes, corneal ulcers, foreign particles about the eyes, fistula lacrimalis and stricture of lacrimal duct. There is intense photophobia, burning, stinging and redness of the eyes. The discharge is thin, watery and copious. In ulceration, the discharge gets thick and yellow like pus. There is falling of eyelashes. Silicea is indicated in syphilitic ulceration of nose. There is formation of hard crust on the nose. There is loss of smell and an offensive discharge, often with epistaxis. Silicea is also indicated in epithelioma. Silicea is indicated in eustachian tube catarrh, chronic suppurative otitis media, rupture of the eardrum and caries of the small bones of the ear and mastoid process. Thus, there is an offensive, thick and yellow otorrhea. The patient complains of noises in ear like roaring, hissing, etc. There is often deafness and it goes on for some time and hearing returns with a snap. There is a feeling of sudden stoppage in ear, better by gaping or swallowing. There is inflammation of tongue going on to abscess formation, tearing pains at night which is ameliorated by heat. There are abscesses about gums and face which is also better by warmth. A severe pain in the jaw, especially at night, ends in abscesses about tooth. Toothache is better by hot drinks and in a warm room. Silicea is also indicated in peritonsillar abscess. In recurrent tonsillitis and pharyngitis, silicea breaks up the tendency. Silicea is indicated in inflammation of salivary glands, especially parotid and sublingual glands, and the cervical glands. The glands become hard and painful. There is pain in neck, shoulders, and head. There is fever with heat of upper part of body and cold extremities. Sweat about head and neck. Contrary to its usual symptoms, there is heat and suffocation in a warm room. Silicea is indicated in abscess about rectum leading to formation of fistula. In those who has chest complaints following surgery for fistula, silicea turns the constitution into order. In prostatitis, there is thick fetid pus from the urethra, abscess along the penis, prostate gland and testis. There is chronic inflammation and induration of testis, which is painful. The symptoms include impotency, weakness of the genitals after coition, much sweating of the genitals. Silicea cures hydrosalpinx and pyosalpinx. There forms a lump on one or other side of uterus which increases steadily. The lump disappears when there is sudden discharge of watery, bloody, purulent fluid. This repeats. Fistula and abscess about vulva and cerasus in vagina. They heal into hard nodules or do not heal at all. The discharge is offensive and cheesy. There is also bloody discharge between periods. Likewise, there could be amenorrhea for months. Silicea is indicated for cancer of the uterus where there is profuse and acrid and milky leucorrhea preceded by cutting around the navel. In threatened abscess of the breast, if silicea is given, it will abort it. In abscess of the breast, there is throbbing pain, tenderness and weight. Silicea controls the pain, hastens the drainage and heals it. Formation of abscess along articular cartilage. In inflammation of periosteum leading to necrosis. Necrosis is usually seen in jaws, hip joint and in vertebrae where it shows lateral curvature. To sum up, silicea hastens the formation of abscesses and boils, cures recurrent fibroids and old indurated tumors, heals old fistula with indurated margins. It also cures ingrowing toenails and cones. If you like today's video, give it a big thumbs up, click subscribe and tap the bell icon to receive notification.